द मुंडक उपनिषद इन सिंपल इंग्लिश पार्ट थ्री द कंक्लूडिंग पार्ट. टू बर्ड्स हु आर कंपेनियंस एंड ऑलवेज यूनाइटेड लिव इन द सेम ट्री. ऑफ द टू वन ईट्स द फ्रूट. इट एक्सपीरियंसेस द प्लेजेंट एंड द पेनफुल फ्रूट्स ऑफ इट्स पास्ट डीड्स व्हाइल द अदर लुक्स ऑन विदाउट ईटिंग. On that very tree, a person immersed in the sorrows of the world is deluded, and feeling helpless and impotent, he grieves and is always sad. However, when he sees and realizes that his other companion on the tree is none other than the Supreme Lord who is worshipped all over, then realizing this and seeing the Lord's greatness, he becomes freed from sorrows. When a seer sees the golden colored creator, the Lord, the person who is the source of Brahma, then becoming a knower, he gets rid of all good and evil. He gets rid of both, and then, free from any stain, he attains equality with the Supreme Lord. Truly, it is life that shines forth in all living beings. Knowing the Lord, knowing Brahm, the wise man does not talk of anything else. Living in the self and delighting in the self and always doing all his works, such a one is the greatest among the knowers of Brahm. This self within the body is of the nature of light and is pure. It can be attained by truth. It can be attained by austerity. It can be attained by right knowledge and by the constant practice of chastity. All who do so, all such ascetics, get rid of all their imperfections and then they behold Him, the Lord. Truth alone conquers. Truth alone prevails, not untruth. By truth alone is laid out the path leading to the gods and the supreme abode of truth, the path travelled by the sages who have fulfilled all their desires. The supreme is vast and infinite. The supreme is divine. The supreme is of unthinkable form and is subtler than the subtle. It always shines forth. It is ever luminous. It is farther than the far, yet it is here, near at hand. Since it dwells in the secret place of the heart, it can be seen as such by the intelligent. The Supreme cannot be grasped by the eye. He cannot be seen by the eyes. He cannot be grasped or known by speech or by any of the sense organs. He cannot be grasped by austerity or by work. The Supreme, who is without parts, can be seen only when one's intellectual nature has been purified by the light of knowledge through meditation. When the senses in five different forms merge and center in the thoughts of a person, only then does the subtle sense become known to him. The whole of man's thought is totally pervaded by the senses. Therefore, when his thoughts are purified, then only does the self shine forth. Whatever world a man of purified desire thinks of in his mind, and whatever desire he desires, all those worlds and all those desires he attains. The knower of the self has all his desires fulfilled, and he can obtain anything or any world that he seeks. Therefore, let him who desires prosperity worship the knower of the self. He knows that supreme abode of Brahm, wherein founded the world shines brightly. The wise men who, freed from desires, worship the person, pass beyond the material cause of embodied birth. They pass beyond birth and death and are not born again. He who entertains desires and who keeps on thinking of them, he therefore on account of such desires and such thoughts is born here and there. But the person who has his desires fully satisfied and who has become a perfected soul, all the desires of such a one vanish even here on earth in his very own lifetime. The self cannot be attained by instruction, nor can it be attained by intellectual power, nor even by hearing again and again. He can be attained only by the one whom the self chooses. To such a one, the self reveals his true nature. The self cannot be attained by one who does not have mental strength, who does not have the inner strength derived from meditation. The self cannot be attained by the careless, or through carelessness, or even through aimless austerity. But he who strives by these means, and if he becomes a knower, then this self of his enters the abode of Brahma, and he attains salvation. Having attained him, the seers who are satisfied with their knowledge, and who are perfected souls, who are free from passion, who are tranquil, and who have attained the omnipresent self on all sides, those wise ones with concentrated minds enter into the all itself. Having found the self in all, they therefore enter into everything, they enter into all. The ascetics who have understood well the meaning of the Vedanta knowledge and who have purified their natures through the path of renunciation, they, dwelling in the worlds of Brahma, the highest immortal, and becoming one with him at the end of time, are all liberated along with Brahma. The 15 parts then go back to their respective supports. The elements and all the sense organs go back into their supporting deities, one's deeds and the self, consisting of understanding, all merge into and become one with the supreme immutable being, the supreme Brahm. Just as the flowing rivers disappear into the ocean, casting off their names and their shape, even so does the knower, freed from name and shape, merge with and attain to the divine person, attain to Brahm, who is higher than the high. He who truly knows the supreme Brahm becomes Brahm himself. In his family, no one who does not know Brahm will ever be born. All will be knowers of Brahm. He crosses over sorrow. He crosses over all sins, liberated from the knots that bind the secret place of the heart. He becomes immortal. This very doctrine is declared in the verses. Those who perform the rites, those who are learned in the scriptures, those who are well established in Brahm, those who offer up themselves as sacrifice to the soul seer with faith, to them alone may one declare this knowledge of Brahm, by whom the rite of carrying fire on the head has been performed according to rule. This is the truth. The sage Angiras declared it before. Let none who has not performed the rite read this. We salute the great sages. We salute the great sages. End of chapter 3, end of part 3, end of Mundak Upanishad. Om, peace, peace, peace.